On several pages, you may have noticed this advanced section. This drag and drop interface for adding specialized content like accordions is our final component of the site. You may choose from 1, 2, or 3 column sections, and you can stack as many as you like on top of each other to achieve your desired look. Let's start with a 1 column section. No matter which type you choose, 1, 2, or 3 columns, you will always have the following options. Section title, and this is exactly what this note says down here. It doesn't show up visibly to users of the site, it's just a title that appears in this editing interface to help you keep track of sections. So, for example, if I put, "This is my section," I can then hit this collapse button, and you'll see that there's now a name to identify this one column advanced section. There's nothing here, so reopening and deleting that. If I hit collapse again, you'll just notice that it says column 1, and it's kind of hard to tell what's actually in this. I can also choose a background color for this section. And for most things, I'm going to just leave it as none though, because this is a prime example of just because you can doesn't mean you should, as too many disparate colors on a page can be distracting. Finally, under column content, I can add my section type. We have accordions, buttons, media, pull quotes, tabs, and text areas. Switching over to a finished page, you can see how each of these manifest in order. Accordions form collapsible text sections. Within each is a rich text field that acts just like the body field above. The main difference comes in headings. Within accordions, you'll be required to use headings starting at level 4. Again, in accordions, you'll be required to use headings starting at level 4. A button creates a highly visible link. This can be used as a call to action. Due to the visibility, these are perfect for links such as Apply Now or View the Project. A media section creates a column spanning image, video, or tweet. Since this is a one column section, it will span the width of the page. This is actually my favorite way of adding videos to a page. Pull quotes are very specialized. If you've ever read through a magazine and seen a sentence from an article pulled out and increased in font size, well, that's a pull quote. The name is almost semantic here. Since this doesn't necessarily represent a quote someone has said, it's a quote from the article itself. Tabs function in a similar style to accordions, with two differences. The first is that tabs go horizontally across the page, so keep in mind that this now constrains the number of tabs you can have. The second is that the first tab is always open. The most important info should go here. If all info in this group is equal, you should probably be using accordions instead. One thing to keep in mind with tabs, that start with heading 4 requirement for accordions, well, it's going to be the same here as well. The final advanced component is the text area. This is simply a repeat of the body field, but one that you can move around, above, or below other advanced sections. An example use would be starting an article in the body field, or text area, adding a pull quote, and then continuing it underneath in another text area. 2 and 3 column sections function almost identically to the one column, the main differences being the ability to put multiple types of sections next to each other in a row. And you can also select the ratio you want each column to be. For example, on these two columns, you can choose to make your columns a straight split, half and half, or you could do something like a 2/3, 1/3. Same deal with the 3 column section. I have the option to split this into 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, or something a little different, such as 1/4, 1/2, 1/4. On my live pages here, you can see a few examples that I put together to showcase this. Now that we've completed this topic, choose the next video on the right side of the screen, or view the entire playlist with the link on the left.